Coming up this week on Winchester Deadly Passion. For many, love is a fickle thing. But for those who are fortunate enough to set foot along the banks of the Powder River in southeast Montana, love is steadfast. And for Melissa Bachman, it's that continual passion that brings her back to this magical place year after year. On this trip, she's hunting with good friend Travis Anderson of Powder River Outfitters, and they both have giant rattling whitetails on the brain. The good news? Whitetails aren't the only option in a place like this.
Think about one state that has such a variety of game across the whole U.S. and you said you can go to one place and you can hunt anything you want, well, it would probably be Montana. And one of the reasons is because they have whitetails, they have mule deer, they have antelope, they've got elk, they've got it all, and they have the numbers. Now, we're not just talking a few deer or a few whitetail. They are loaded up. And where I hunt down on the Powder River, I go with Powder River Outfitters year after year, and it's simple why. Because they have the highest percentage of whitetails I probably know of. In fact, if someone ever asked me, where would be the one place you would go with the highest percentage chance to get a 130-inch buck or better, hands down, the Powder River.
We're in the southeast corner of Montana, close to Broadus. The terrain is river bottoms and river breaks, and got some pine timber country and a lot of big rolling flats. We got mule deer and whitetail, really good antelope, and quite a few elk in here. Pheasants, shark tails, huns, kind of got anything somebody wants.
Now that doesn't mean you're necessarily going to shoot a 180 or a 200 inch deer, but they're also there. And what I like about it is you're not just going after one species. In fact, your tag is good for both mule deer and whitetails. So you may have it in mind that you want to shoot one or the other, but if you get a beautiful deer in front of you, well, that's totally up to you. Your tag is good for either one. Just comes down to your decision. So what are you thinking for this morning?
I thought we'd ease down my riverbank here and get the wind right. There's a big oxbow in this river that them deer have been staying in. I thought we'd get in there and try to rattle them out since they're not coming to the fields anymore.
You've been seeing some pretty good ones in there?
Yeah, we've been seeing some really nice deer. There's a lot of short green grass in there that they're getting, so.
Okay, I'll follow you.
All right.
So once you decide that you're gonna go to Montana, now you gotta decide what time of the year is best. Now every season, well, it has different advantages. In fact, I've hunted all the different times. So when you come early season, I've done that. It's a bow hunt, you're out, it's nice and green, and you have the chance at shooting a velvet whitetail. There's not many places in the United States that you have that opportunity anymore. In fact, a couple years ago, well, I was there and I was chasing this beautiful, probably 160-inch whitetail all around, and I never did get on him. Every single night he came out to the same field, but unfortunately, never once did he take the same path, and I was never able to get a chance at him. But I've also come where I was filming myself, finally patterned the deer out, had a nice buck come right down the lane. I had sat there the night before, saw where they were coming. Kenny and I moved the stand, got on them, and got my shot, got a beautiful buck. But that's some of the advantages to early season hunting. Now on this hunt, well, I was gonna be doing a late season hunt. Now one of the things I like about the late season hunt is number one, you're hunting with a gun, but number two, you're close to that peak of the rut. I like to hunt right around Thanksgiving because those bucks are usually on their feet, pushing around does, and they're ready for a fight.
This segment was brought to you by Sportsman's Alliance. Our heritage, our fight. Protecting hunting from coast to coast.
Did you know that hunters are essentially the backbone of conservation in the U.S.? We provide 75% of the funding for all 50 state fish and game agencies and have contributed more than $14 billion to on-the-ground habitat and conservation projects, and these are projects that protect both game and non-game species alike. Just another fun fact showing how sportsmen and women are helping make a difference. Most of my fall, well, I spend it sitting dark to dark in either a tree stand or a ground blind, and I'm putting in my time. So by Thanksgiving, well, if I have an opportunity to do something other than sit in a stand, well, I'll usually take it. And in Montana, one of the best ways to hunt is to go down on those river bottoms and rattle and bring those big bucks out to you. Not only is it probably the most exciting way to hunt, but it's also extremely efficient because you're not just waiting for them to come by. Sure, you'll have good activity in the morning and the evening, but you can get active, you can make things happen, and that's what I absolutely love.
Well, the biggest thing to me is that there's so many bucks compared to most other places, you know. A lot of days you'll see 18 to 30 bucks, you know, and you may see 100, 150 does, so that keeps them bucks real busy all the time, and they're chasing and really aggressive most of the time, so the rattling is a lot of fun.
Out there trying to rattle, there's a lot of things you need to take into account. One of the most important things is the fact that these deer are in the thick Russian olives, so you want to pull them out. So it's really important to know the area, to know the lay of the land. You want the wind in your favor, you want to be able to get close enough so these deer can hear you. And depending on how windy it is, they may not be able to hear you, so you may need to stop and rattle every 150, 200 yards and make sure you wait it out, because those rattling antlers, they sound off from a long way. So if you rattle and you just leave and pack up shop in 5 minutes, you may have had a buck coming from 500-600 yards away, and you may have busted him out and he hadn't got to you yet. So patience is a virtue. The next thing, you really want to make sure that where you stop to rattle, that you've put some thought into it. You want to try to get some back cover if possible so you don't silhouette yourself, and you want to have a rest. I always have a tripod because I want to be rock solid. I don't know if there's necessarily going to be a tree to lean on, so I want to know that I have a great setup, because when that buck comes in, he is going to be searching for you, and you want to make sure you're rock solid because there's not going to be any time to move around. As soon as you see a deer, you quit rattling, you quit grunting, and you let him search for you. We were covering a lot of ground and we were bringing deer out, but they were all small bucks. And I know that this area isn't just full of small bucks. There's big bucks too. But for whatever reason, the big bucks weren't reacting. The small deer were coming in. Now, one thing to remember is you're gonna have small bucks come in, they're also gonna run off. Doesn't necessarily mean that's a bad thing. You haven't blown the spot. Just start rattling again, grunt, and set up, and always be watching. We had the perfect setup. We had all the right ground, all the right equipment. We just couldn't bring a big buck in to save our life. Well, it is just not working right now. We saw those bucks. They didn't want anything to do with it.
No. All the good bucks, when they start rattling, they bed down.
You're putting them to sleep.
Yeah. It's not the way it's supposed to go.
I don't know what to think other than they've got to be with does and they're just not interested in fighting.
I think that's right.
Well, what do you think plan B should be?
Well, we'll go sit in the field and wait for them to come out, I guess.
Okay. I mean, we saw tons of them last night, so I think it's going to be, I mean, I think it's a really good option.
Yeah.
They're coming out.
Yeah.
Sounds like a plan.
Yeah, thank you.
Now, Travis had asked me before the hunt, you want to hunt whitetails, you want to hunt mule deer? Because yes, you can hunt both, but usually they're in different areas. The whitetails are down on that Powder River in the river bottoms, the mule deer are up in the hills. Well, I said, I'd probably like to hunt whitetails, but if we see a big muley, I don't have any problem with that either.
A hunter can expect to take either one. The mule deer hunting is really good, and the whitetail hunting is extremely good. And you know, in any day you can see 10 bucks of each kind, you know, mule deer or whitetail. And a lot of times we'll be hunting whitetail and run into a mule deer on the river, or be hunting mule deer and run into whitetails in the hills.
As we were switching locations, we had gone all over on the bottoms, trying different things. We were heading to a brand new ranch, and all of a sudden, we spotted a muley way out there. Now, I wasn't even sure it was a mule deer, it was so far, but Travis said, that is a nice one. So we decided, you know what, we're gonna make a stalk on him. I didn't know if it would work. The winds were howling, it was freezing out, but we were gonna give it a try.
This segment was brought to you by Boss Buck. For the most user-friendly and dependable feeder on the market, choose Boss Buck feeders. Now you're getting serious. Winchester Deadly Passion is presented by Cuttyback Digital. More deer, fewer blanks. Hard-hitting Easton arrows. Hunter's safety system. Winchester repeating arms. Analogics, protect your deer herd with the power of science. Scent killer goal with Hunt Dry technology. Apply it, dry it, and go hunt. Rage Broadheads, leading the evolution in lethal technology. Sportsman's Alliance, protecting hunting from coast to coast. Engel Coolers, the original high-performance cooler company. And Golden Triangle Whitetail, your hunt of a lifetime awaits.
If someone asked me, where do you think the absolute highest percentage chance you have to go kill a whitetail would be, I'd have to say Montana and on the Powder River. There's one coming right here, right there. Now, of course, there's a lot of great things about hunting during the rut, hunting around that Thanksgiving time. But the bad part is, boy, you can run into some nasty weather. In fact, I've been there in the past. We got 12 inches one year when we were out hunting. Adam Groning and I, we were having so much fun. I barely even noticed it was snowing, and we looked like little snowmen out there. We had the perfect camouflage on, probably one of the most enjoyable hunts ever. This time, it wasn't snowing. It was just downright cold and windy, and there's nothing that can cut that wind. You're just out in those elements, your skin is exposed, and it can be downright miserable. But Travis and I, we weren't giving up. We had spotted a mule deer. We were gonna try to use that wind to our advantage.
Well, I think we can go down this draw and get below them, and then go up the other side and come right out above them. They're laying on that little knoll.
I think we got a strong enough wind that we can probably get, you know, once we get there, as long as we don't get skyline too much, we should be able to get right in on them.
You bet. You know, you can expect to see a mule deer anywhere. You can expect to see a whitetail anywhere. I mean, they intermingle all the time. That's what makes it so fun, is because of the unknown. And we have so many acres and so many different ranches. Every day we get to see new animals, you know. So as a guide or a outfitter, it's very, very exciting, because every day you have the chance to run into that one that you really, really want to see. I think that deer is right up over the top up here. I think we can slip right up through the sagebrush and get high enough where we can see.
We should have a pretty good wind. Him and that doe were just bedded right in there.
Yep, just right over the top.
One of the best parts about where mule deer live is they're actually in country that has a little roll to it. So we were hoping to get behind one hill. We had made a plan. We just wanted to sneak over the top, and that was as close as we were going to get.
Which way from that
dog? He's getting up, he's kind of walking away.
Yep, I see him walking away.
And there was our deer. He looked like a beautiful buck, but I just wasn't comfortable. I knew this was a lot longer shot than I wanted, so I needed to get completely rock solid. And Travis, he's just awesome. He's trying to calm me down. He's as calm as a cucumber, and I know he's not.
I get as excited as the hunter, and a lot of times more excited.
I squeezed the trigger, and I just saw that deer fall right in the scope.
Could you see the shot?
Yeah, you dropped him. Oh, right in his tracks.
That's awesome. I shot, it felt great, but I got the recoil, I couldn't even see where he went. He's a
good
nice
job.
Mule deer.
Yeah, he's really great.
Oh, that is awesome. The size of his neck and these. I don't know if I've ever seen eye guards on a mule deer like that.
Oh, them are really good ones.
What do you got, to mix them with whitetails out here?
Travis and I, we were so happy. We had put in all this time, and we weren't necessarily expecting to get a mule deer, but boy, was I happy that it all worked out.
Tip of the Week is brought to you by Field & Stream. Trusted brands, timeless traditions.
Now I just wrapped up a morning hunt, and then I actually decided to move one of my blinds. And when I moved it, I wanted it to blend in, so, well, the closest thing I could find is a bunch of mud around. Mudded it all up, now that blind has no sheen. Trouble is, now I've got some muddy hands and I'm coming back for lunch. So one of the things I like to do is keep some Scent Killer Gold, the foaming hand wash, right in the back of my truck. And the reason is simple. It has a really easy rinse formula, and you don't need a lot of water. So you can just squirt it right in your hands, and then just rub them together, and it has no scent, so you don't have to worry about going back out after whitetails and having them spook off from some scented soap that you're using. But the nice part is, you can lather it up, and all you really need is a simple bottle of water. You can rinse it right off. It doesn't take much at all, so it works nice for the back of your truck, or let's say you're in camp somewhere and you don't have a lot of access to water. It really works great. Also, if you've been doing any gutting deer or anything and have blood on your hands, it works well there too. So in the end, it's just nice to keep right in your truck. That way you can clean up, you don't have to worry about scent when you go back into the field, and you can have an excellent hunt.
Winchester Deadly Passion is presented by Winchester, the American legend. Matthews Archery, catch us if you can. Field & Stream, where traditions begin. ScoutLookWeather.com. Download the free Deer Log app for your smartphone. Reinhardt, the best archery targets in the world. Sure Shot Jewelry. Check out the Melissa Bachman collection today. And Boss Buck, for the most user-friendly and dependable feeder on the market. Now you're getting serious. Closed captioning is brought to you by Cuddyback Digital. Upgrade to Cuddyback, and your images will never look better.
Regardless of where you're hunting in the country or what type of animals you're going after, one of the key things to make anyone a successful hunter is probably knowing the terrain. Not only to look and see where those animals might be, but how to get to them best. And when you're out on the Powder River, they literally have hundreds of thousands of acres. So you don't have time to hunt the whole thing, so you need to know where the best parts are. And that's why scouting is so important. And with someone like Travis Anderson, he's out there all the time. He's scouting. In Montana, you can't use trail cams all year, but you can use them in the early season. So he's got cameras out. He's seeing what the bucks are doing, and he's out there watching them. And it truly can make a world of difference when it comes time to your hunt. You don't want to go to Montana and just be completely blind when you're paying for a hunt. You want to go with someone who has the knowledge. And with someone like Travis, you get a knowledgeable person and someone who's a ton of fun.
Well, I'll walk across like this. If I fall in, I shouldn't go under.
There you go. I'll follow you.
So with my beautiful mule deer down, well, we still had a little bit of time left in camp, and we wanted to go out, do some other filming, and I thought, you know what? One of the most important things is to have people who enjoy hunting, who enjoy being outdoors, and my cameraman, Martin Teeter, he loves it.
We just got set up here again. We're gonna try another rattling sequence. Travis is set up about 65, 70 yards behind us. I am lucky enough to actually be hunting. I'm usually running the camera for Melissa, and I had a Montana tag, so I was able to get out here and get behind the gun for a couple days. And now we're gonna see if Melissa remembers how to run one of those cameras. Hopefully I can remember how to shoot a deer, and she can remember how to hit record.
and focus and all the other good stuff.
Well, it didn't take long. Travis was over, rattling on his own. I flipped the camera over, and this buck is running so fast, I can barely even tell if he's in focus. I'm trying to get going, and that's how it's supposed to work. We had been out there, that's all we had been looking for this whole time. And of course, after I get my deer, that's exactly how it works.
What do you think? Pretty nice, isn't he?
Yeah, he is.
It's a good buck. Like I said, it's been several years since I've shot a whitetail buck.
Yeah.
So I'm pretty pumped to get anything, but this buck's real nice.
Oh, it's the best. It's like getting to hunt every day. You know, I've hunted my whole life since my dad took me when I was 6, 7 years old, you know. And it's more exciting for me to see somebody get something now than it is myself.
This episode, Melissa was hunting with Travis Anderson of Powder River Outfitters. To book your Montana deer hunt, visit powder-river-outfitters.com and tell them Melissa sent you. Follow Melissa on Twitter at Melissa Bachman, on Facebook at facebook.com/Winchester Deadly Passion, and Instagram at Melissa_Bachman for behind-the-scenes footage, photos, giveaways, and much more.